Message that you gave me from you, Lord, it's not Minister Clarke's word, that you gave me to share with your people, Lord. And I hope it falls on listening ears and humble hearts, Lord. And this blessed reaction, in Jesus' name, you may be seated. Amen. Matthew 6:30. I'm gonna read it again just so we can keep moving. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. For tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. The theme or the title that I gave for this scripture, for this sermon, is Take One Day at a Time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So now y'all know why I asked Big Mama to sing that. And this verse, I see three things. I see why worry. I see its own worry, and I see enough worry.
Amen.
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 Amen. People who are struggling with addiction or alcoholism, stuff like that, while they are in recovery, they often cling to a set of guiding statements as they work to stay clean and or sober. The most common statement used in these situations is one day at a time. And that is because there is no value in those people worrying about whether they will fall into temptation tomorrow.
Amen.
Their addiction must be fought today. Tomorrow's fight will take place tomorrow. In overcoming addiction effectively, such people are taught to focus on winning today's battles. This concept is compatible with the principles found in this command from Jesus. He tells us as his followers not to worry about tomorrow. As we all know, and as Jesus has said, worrying ain't gonna fix nothing. Okay, Jesus didn't say it like that, but that's you get me? That's the way he talked to him. That's the way I put it. Worry ain't gonna fix nothing. A songwriter put it like this: that problem that I had, I stopped worrying about it, turned it over to Jesus, and he worked it out. Didn't he work it out? Anxiety over things you cannot control or are out of our reach makes no sense whatsoever. God, who loves us and already knows not only what he wants to accomplish, but he also knows what we need to make what he wants to accomplish happen. So in short, what Jesus is saying is that born-again believers should let tomorrow worry about itself. And take one day at a time. Jesus is not saying, however, that Christians cannot or should not make wise plans. Nor is Jesus saying believers are to literally ignore anything but the most immediate questions or circumstances. What Jesus is talking about here is the emotions of fear and anxiety. You know those feelings of worry, nervousness, uneasiness. But those of us who trust in God should not wallow in useless worry about the future. Tomorrow's fight will happen tomorrow. The battle to trust God and not ourselves is always happening in the current moment. You know, a lot of times we think we got everything under control. And all we're doing is fighting battles that are not ours. Sometimes the battle is not ours. It's the Lord's. Today has plenty of trouble with which we need to trust God. So here Jesus is commanding us as his followers to focus on trusting God in a moment by moment way. We shouldn't try to solve all of our problems for all times at one time. Let God provide what is needed day by day.
Amen.
Take one day at a time.
Amen.
Which brings me to my first point. So why worry? It's right there in the first part, 34, it says, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow. We can always seem to find something to worry about. The ignorant worry because they think they don't know enough. The intelligent worry because they think they know too much. The rich worry in fear of losing what they have. The poor worry in fear of not having enough. The old worry because they are facing death. The young worry because they're facing life. Everybody worrying about something. If you go back a few verses to verse 27, and you'll see Jesus ask this question: who of you by worrying can add a single day to his life? Now, worrying could shorten your life. You know, you worrying so much that your blood pressure goes up and everything, that's going to have a stroke. But worrying is not going to add nothing to your life. When we worry, It's like we put a wound in the heart of God. I know y'all going like, whoa, what you talking about, preacher? But doesn't God's word say he will never leave nor forsake us? Doesn't God's word say, if God be for us, who can be against us? Does God lie? Or as somebody put it, he may not come when you want, but he'll be there right on time. And not only is worry a wound in the heart of God, especially if you say and call yourself a follower of Christ, but it is also an insult to God. And you go, oh my goodness, what you talking about now? How am I insulting God if I'm worrying? Okay. Worrying will have you living like a non-believer instead of living like someone who has a heavenly Father. Worry is the opposite of faith. You ever heard that expression, you're going to worry, don't pray? If you're going to pray, don't worry. So worry is the opposite of faith. In Hebrews 11, it says, no one can please God without faith. For whoever comes to God must have faith and believe that God exists and rewards those who seek him. Worry will bury your blessings. Blessings are all around all of us all the time. If you take a closer look, like you're not in the hospital, you in the right mind, you got activity of your limbs, you walk, you can see, you can hear, you can talk, you can bathe yourself, you can even wipe your own behind. Some people can't do that, but even those people that can't, they blessed to have somebody that can. And if you're blind, you can still hear, you can still talk. So, you know, your blessings is all around. You just don't look at them all the time. And worry will blind you of the blessings of today that you should be praising and thanking God for today. Amen. Amen. See, we're always in a hurry. You know, we live in this, what they call microwave world now. We want everything right now. But we should not be in a hurry for tomorrow. Because hurrying creates worrying. And worrying can be contagious. It can spread gloom everywhere. You worried about something so much that it's going to make somebody worry about you. And you worried about them and somebody your loved one's worrying about you, worrying about them. Right? Worry about, and all the time, it's taking joy out of today. Worry can steal your joy and take away your strength. If we keep piling tomorrow's problems on today's, it will break us down. You arrive at tomorrow, you're tired, you're out of breath, and worn down because you've been carrying around a double load of today's and tomorrow's problems that God did not intend for you to carry. Take one day at a time. You cannot live in the past. Yesterday gone. You can't live in the future because tomorrow ain't promised you. You can only live in today. When you worry about tomorrow's problem, you will miss the blessings of today. And not only that, you can't solve tomorrow's problem with today's problem. When tomorrow arrives and becomes today, God will give you the power, the perspective, the grace, and the wisdom you need for tomorrow. Amen. Take one day at a time. Now, in the same chapter, in verse 11, is we're starting, you know, first in chapter where Jesus said, when he was talking on the Sermon on the Mount, where he tells people how they should pray, which has now become known as the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven. What's praying he says, or what he does not say, is give us this week our monthly bread. He don't say it. He says, give us this day our daily bread. God wants us to depend on him and to rely on him one day at a time. Which takes me back to my second point. His own word. It's the second part of 34. It says, for tomorrow will worry about itself. And you say, what does that mean, preacher? Well, a man by the name of Tony Evans put it this way in one of his Bible commentaries. Today is the tomorrow you were worried about yesterday. An antidote for worry is focusing on living for God's kingdom. So if you keep your focus on God, you ain't gonna have time to worry. Because you know he got you. Now the Bible doesn't shy away from the difficulty of living in this fallen world. Ever since Adam and Eve exited from the garden, after succumbing to the temptation of Satan, life on earth has been full of turmoil, trouble, trials, tribulations, and sin. Tomorrow's trouble will take care of itself. If you don't think tomorrow, you don't know what tomorrow's trouble is going to be, watch the news tomorrow night. This world is just full of trouble. So we can't be worrying about what's coming. And while the pain of life can feel excruciating and tempt us to worry, we as believers are not left alone to deal with. We have a comforter that Jesus left for us, that being the Holy Spirit. The Spirit helps us in our weakness, and the Spirit himself intercedes for us to the one that searches hearts. You know, man looks at the inside, outward appearance. God searches the heart. So that's when the Holy Ghost intercedes for us. That being God, God knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that those who love God, all things work for their good. Work together for their good. So we can let tomorrow worry about itself when we keep our focus on God. We are not left to navigate the storms of life by frantically grabbing for the steering wheel and thinking that any and everything all depends on us to control every future event and circumstance which might be possible but cannot be predicted, be predicted with any real certainty. Rather, we serve a God that holds all creation in his hands.
Amen.
The one who knows the end since the beginning, the one who is Lord of lords, the one who is King of kings,
yes.
The one who is all-powerful, the one who is all-knowing, the one who is the one and only true and living Almighty Father God.
Amen. Amen.
With him on our side, tomorrow can bring whatever we want to bring.
Amen. Amen.
So as long as we keep our mind stayed on Jesus and keep the faith, we won't have to worry about what tomorrow will bring. So you just keep your mind on Jesus. It's like when Jesus walking on water. Peter come out and says, "That you, Lord? Tell me to come, and I'll come." So he said, "Come up here." Peter started walking on the water, going to Jesus. Soon as he looked at the water and seen the waves and stuff, took his eyes and his focus off of Jesus, he started to sing. It's the same thing with us. You take your eyes off, that's what's going to happen. And you know he's with you. The same way he was on the other boat when he was asleep. And the storm came up. Everybody ran to him. Wait on. Oh, Lord, Rabbi, don't you know we're going to perish? We're scared. Where did Jesus up? Jesus get up, you know, and said, "Peace be still." And everything stopped. And Jesus right there with him. So, you know, if you keep your focus on him, he got you. Right? And then where we give them way to peace happens when we are aware of God's powerful presence. That's what I'm just talking about with us. Because God's presence is something that cannot be manipulated, be negotiated, or be earned. Rather, it is a constant. He's always there. That we become increasingly attuned to and aware of through prayer. That's how we talk to God, through prayer, through Jesus. It is through this prayerful communion with God that we can learn to say, and say confidently, we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us, because God is love. And whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in them.
Amen?
Amen. Moving right along here. Matthew 6:34c, this is my last point. So each day has enough trouble of its own. As we rely on God and his love for us, we can entrust our future into his hands, choosing to live in the present enjoyment of his presence. Each day has enough trouble of its own, and we know that in any trouble we face, we are not alone. For the one who provides for the birds of the air and the flowers of the field, the one who has authority over storms and who created and holds the world together, is with us and for us. Each day has enough trouble of its own, so we need to try to remain in the present and focus on the challenges we are facing today. When we learn, then we know, and we meditate on the Word of God, we will realize that it is the ultimate source of the peace that surpasses all understanding. Worrying about tomorrow is like trying to cross a bridge before you get to it. It's like putting the horse in front of the cart or the cab. That's not going nowhere. You can't cross a bridge until you get to it. So don't trouble with trouble until trouble troubles you. Worrying accomplishes nothing but making you miserable. Put your trust in the Lord. Worry won't add a single hour to your lifespan. Take one day at a time. Jesus assures us that we are ever in his care, now and forever. Take one day at a time. God's steadfast love is ever available to strengthen us in our times of trouble. Take one day at a time. Jesus calls us to take heart and rely on our faith to support us. Take one day at a time. Cast aside your fear. The Lord is with you. Take one day at a time. The peace of the Lord far surpasses any assurance the world can give. Take one day at a time. If your faith is strong, there's nothing that can shake you. Take one day at a time. God knows your needs and will never forsake you. Take one day at a time. Don't let worries about the future overwhelm you. Turn to the Lord for support in the present. Take one day at a time. Let your mind be at ease. God's love surrounds you. Take one day at a time. And finally, my sister and brother, if God is on your side, the fears of the world will never overwhelm you. Take one day at a time.